everybody. Lance Russell and Dave Bryan right along ringside, ready to go with another big day on Championship Wrestling. And boy, what a biggie this is, David.
Listen, I'm excited about this one. We've got a CWA heavyweight tournament match today right here on television.
First time it has ever happened that we've had a major title like this, and it's going to be established with a tournament on TV today.
That belt has been held up. We'll have a preliminary match or two, and then they'll take a breather and come back for the finals. There will be a champion crowned here today.
Right.
Absolutely.
This very day. Boy, we've got the whole explanation. We got some other things, huh?
Yeah,
standby
okay.
Matches.
The
and all.
Standby matches coming up. One of the matches today, Brickhouse Brown will be going against Mean Mike Miller. That's one of the preliminaries. And the other one, Brian Lee goes against Tommy Lane from the Rock and Roll RPM. So those are the preliminary matches. There will be a champion crown right here today. Sid Vicious will be here in a match, too.
Yeah.
And standby match, if there's time for it, with time limits being what they are and all of that, Robert Fuller, Jimmy Golden, Mike Davis going against Scott Steiner, Brian Adams, and Todd Morton. Is that a standby or not?
That is a standby and a half, and we'll see if we have the opportunity to do it. We'll have a whole explanation. I got some tape I want to show you about what brought this on, and we'll be back to do that in just a moment. And the way it came about was the most interesting thing. There was a match with Phil Hickerson defending against Brian Lee, which we saw the beginning of right here.
Right.
Lee had gotten an unexpected and an unscheduled win over him because there was no match, and Phil Hickerson jumped in and so forth, and Lee got a win on him. And that ended up in a challenge match.
Right.
So they had it. Now let me show you some videotape, and you got to pay close attention to this particular one. Phil Hickerson, Brian Lee for the CWA heavyweight title. Here it is.
Goes Brian Lee, and the referee got in the way. And look out, Brian Lee. Hickerson now kicks referee Frank Morrell. I don't know if he so kicked him or not.
Boy, I don't either, but that's a disqualification, no question about it. And here comes Jerry Calhoun down. Count of one, two, three, and four. Goes in after Brian Lee, grabs Calhoun, throws him through the rope out on the concrete floor, pulls a chain out. He comes over to Lee, gloms him with that right hand, takes him down, and now Frank Morrell is up. Hickerson covers one, two, three. Morrell doesn't know that it was all over with Jerry Calhoun, and Hickerson raises his hand. Grabs the belt, and here comes Eddie Marlin.
Phil Hickerson, come here just a second. I want to talk to you. You've been having your way in this area for a long time. This man counted Brian Lee. Brian Lee, as far as I'm concerned, he won the belt, but he counted
that. That's right. This referee that was assigned to my match counted that boy out. That's right, Marlon. You got that right. This man was assigned to my match. I beat him. He's seen me beat him. One, two, three. That's all it counts.
Well, wait just a minute. Let me see the belt a minute.
Okay, you see all you want.
You're not getting this belt, Phil Hickerson. I'm holding the belt up.
Well, in between all of the bleeps of Phil Hickerson in there, Phil Hickerson, I think you heard him say, I quit.
Quit,
there.
Yeah.
What we did not see, but you heard our radio sidekick, Roger Webb, talking about that Frank Morrell had been knocked down. That's when Jerry Calhoun came to the ring, and thereby we had the two referees involved in two different decisions. And he did what he had to do. He held it up and said, you're going to have to fight somebody in order to get the belt on it. Hickerson said, I quit. And he did. He quit the CWA and walked out on it. Eddie wanted a champion. Normally, we would have this in an auditorium or coliseum somewhere, but Eddie wanted, always looking for something to enhance a television show. Today, a one-day tournament is going to be held right here. And before we're through, buddy, we're going to have us a new CWA heavyweight title holder. Okay, one guy who was automatically in. Eddie thought it was only fair. Hickerson quit, or he would have been in it, too. But Brian Lee, certainly, because he was involved in it. Everybody else wanted, oh, yeah, I want in the tournament. I want in the tournament. There's no way we could have 35 matches here on TV today. So they needed three places in there. They had a blind drawing, and the drawing came out with, of course, Brian Lee already in it, Brickhouse Brown, Mean Mike Miller, and Tommy Lane of the RPMs were the other guys that qualified for it. So what we're going to do is have the tournament right here. One fall, 20-minute preliminary matches, which still leaves us time in there for another 20-minute match that we would have for the championship to establish it. But in the event there's a draw, Dave,
yes,
we're going to have the flip of the coin. Don't like it, but it's got to be done today. It will be done today, and we will have a champion. Let's get them all so we can see how all this action's going. One fall, 20-minute time limits, and then the final match
is going to be one fall, but to the TV time limit. So, in other words, when we have to go off the air, if time runs out, then that's when we'll have to go to that coin flip.
So it could be a 20-minute or a 30-minute
or 30 or whatever.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. With Downtown Bruno in his corner, Mean Mike Miller, big 260-pounder out of Baton Rouge, Louisiana, and giving away a lot of weight, but a real battler on the other side of the ring out of Miami, Florida, 225 pounds, Brickhouse Brown. This match, one fall, 20-minute time limit. It's the opening preliminary match of the CWA Heavyweight Tournament. The winner of this match will be against the winner of another preliminary match, and the winner of this one is going to get a shot at the belt.
Hold time. Don't even come near me after what you pulled in there. I don't want to be even talking to you, Bruno.
You know, Lance, I finally figured out that Jerry Young and Cactus Jack were just scumbags, scum of the earth. Downtown Bruno is back where he belongs, back with the stable. Because you know what, Lance? I am not interested in having all these slimy, smelly, stinking people, ugly women, fat guys, bald-headed people, and little goofy kids liking me. I don't need them on my side.
You don't have to worry about that. Listen, we got a championship possible match coming up here, and we want to see what's happening in there. Davey?
Well, we got Brickhouse Brown really taking control here as Mean Mike Miller tried to drop with an elbow a moment ago, and Brickhouse moved out of the way. Brickhouse, veteran that he is, immediately grabbed Miller, and he has really been firing him back and forth across that ring, and you can see Brickhouse Brown as he is in charge right now.
We know a lot more about Brickhouse than we do Miller. I think the folks that follow the magazines and so forth are well aware of the fact that Miller was a scourge of the West Coast. He was very, very big out on the West Coast. He comes in with quite a reputation, and what we've seen of him, he deserves a reputation. Brickhouse! Good clothesline puts him down on his back, and that's putting a lot of weight on that canvas, Davey.
Certainly is. I tell you what, as they step through the ropes there at the opening, just all of a sudden you think, wow, Brickhouse has given away 40 pounds or more, and Mean Mike didn't get that name Mean just by being a Boy Scout throughout his wrestling career.
That's true.
So you felt like, hey, this one may not last long. It's going to be all Mean Mike. Well, Brickhouse showed he can battle him. Well, now, right now, Mean Mike, he just jabbed him in the throat with the point of the fingers. That's illegal. Mike Miller is beginning, looks like, to take over things here. He's got Brickhouse back in the corner. Downtown Bruno, remember, in the corner of Mean Mike Miller. He can't discount him at all.
Good point, because you sure can't. That sneaky son of a gun, he would turn his back and do anything on anybody. It's just no question he has got to be considered a factor. Look at Brickhouse coming firing back, and Miller stops him with a right hand, clubs him across the back. This is the first of the preliminary matches. There will be two, and then we're going to come back with a TV time on the final championship match. Brickhouse and Mean Mike going at it right now.
Mean Mike Miller has the count tolling away as the referee's trying to get him to quit pulling hair.
Ooh.
Oh, is that a mean one or not?
Oh, I'm telling you, he caught him right up under the chin or right on the chin and dumped him hard down there. Picking Brickhouse up. Brick shoots a right to the midsection, into the jaw. And Brickhouse, rugged battler out of Miami, Florida, unloaded with that right hand, and Mean Mike is back on the canvas.
Brickhouse needed that, kind of like a football team. Brickhouse needed to get the momentum going his way rather than Mean Mike. He's got him knocked down to the mat. Downtown Bruno up on the apron. Brickhouse with a shot to the head for Downtown. Concentrating on him, though, and Mean Mike got him from behind. Uh-oh, look out. That reverse neck breaker by Mean Mike. This might be it. Count is two and three, and Mean Mike Miller is going to advance to the finals of the tournament with a win over Brickhouse Brown. But you got to give Bruno an assist there. He was up on the apron. He distracted Brickhouse Brown and allowed Miller to get the three count.
Even though he didn't overtly grab a foot or anything like that, he was just as much responsible for Brick. Of course, Brick let himself get distracted in there, and that's what Bruno is very, very good at. Mean Mike Miller advances, as Dave said, to the finals, and we're going to be having the other preliminary match in just one moment.
Before we announce the Big Evansville card for Wednesday night, let me remind you, wrestling action on Friday, December 16th, Owensboro, Kentucky at the Sports Arena at 8 o'clock. Wednesday night, the Evansville Coliseum. Big wrestling action. Scott Steiner opens up against Mike Davis. Brian Adams against Tommy Lane. A CWA title match as Brian Lee takes on Mean Mike Miller. A bounty match, General Skandar Akbar is sending in the Pit Viper, complete with his 13-foot, 100-pound snake, to take on Jeff Jarrett. A Southern Tag Team title match, special challenge, Robert Fuller and Jimmy Golden with Sylvia and, of course, Downtown Bruno will take on Rick Casey and superstar Bill Dundee. And the big main event, a return grudge match, superstar Billy against Sid Vicious. With me right now, the stud stable, Robert Fuller, Jimmy Golden, and Sylvia.
Yeah, you know, and happy days are here again, baby, because you're looking now at your Southern Tag Team Champion and the prettiest thing right here that will ever show its face in Indiana. And I can guarantee you that, baby, because I know about my girls. But what I do want to get down to, Dundee, and I want to clarify it greatly, son, here's a guy that just had his young punk pimple face boys neck pulled about 4 foot longer than what it's supposed to be, and he's real mad about it. I'm going to tell you something, Dundee. When you get mad and you want to get even, son, you don't go out looking for other young men, and I'm talking about Rick Casey right now at this point, that have had their demise with this company right here, the Stud Stable, that have laid down there with their legs bent back and wrapped around their neck some way and spent a lot of time in the hospital, baby. I'm going to tell you something, Casey, and I'm going to tell you something, Dundee. Casey, he's going right back where he was before. I'm saying to the hospital with his leg in the same condition it was in before. And Dundee, we're not going to let you off so easy, son. We're not going to take you down and break your legs right yet. We're just going to warm you up real good for the darndest whipping you're ever going to have in all your life. They don't whip people in Australia like that big boy's going to whip you, son.
Well, the CWA cameras were out again. A little lunch and aerobics with Beauty and the Beast.
For all you cretinous humanoids out there, I'm sure that you stay in a constant state of depression. Well, I just want to let you know that what Mr. Terrence Garvin, the Beauty, does when he gets a little depressed is watch his favorite show. Maybe y'all ought to try this.
What do you think, Cookie? Huh?
Richard!
Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, come on. One, two, three, five, stretch it down. 15, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
beast.
Yes, Mr. Duggan.
Rich has got me worn out. I've been through the tape 3 times already. I'm famished. I think Chinese should be on the agenda today. So why don't you go get us some Chinese food? Beast, hurry, hurry. I'm famished. Richard's had me worn out this morning. Oh, it was so good. Hurry, get yours. Hurry, hurry. I'm just famished this morning. Hey, Dad. Get yours now. I'm going to eat with chopsticks. I don't know if you can do that. Just try hard if you can't. There's a fork. Now listen, you know, winter's coming on, Beast, and I need some new clothes because I have to be fashionable, you know, going around here town to town. So, listen, would you do me a favor? And this week, call Mario and get the limousine gassed up and ready to go. And I think I need a fur, a full-length fur. What do you think? I think that'd be great.
Just going to be an out-of-town shopping spree.
Oh, no. We'll be right here in town, but I want you to take care of that for me and get that ready now, and as soon as you can, okay?
I'll do that.
Might even want to do that right after we get finished eating. Here, here.
Okay, we finished with Beauty and the Beast. Let's go to the ring for our next preliminary match. David.
Yes, sir. Winner of this match gets a shot at the CWA heavyweight title today. And on one side of the ring, it's going to be one of the rock and roll RPMs. Tommy Lane out of Atlanta, Georgia. His partner Mike Davis is at ringside. We don't like that, but he is going to act, I suppose, as a manager in second. And going against him out of Orlando, Florida, 248 pounds, Brian Lee. One fall, 20-minute time limit. Jerry Calhoun has just called for the bell. Tommy Lane, Brian Lee. Brian Lee with a height advantage. Tommy Lane with an experience advantage. And don't forget Mike Davis back in his corner.
Yeah, we have to look back to the first preliminary match with Downtown Bruno on the outside, and we know how that came out. So does Brickhouse Brown, as Mike Miller ended up winning when Brick was distracted by Downtown Bruno. Tommy Lane, a good point you make about the experience, man. He really has got it. But this kid has really looked super, you know, for a young fella.
Yeah, he beat Junior last week, who was Phil Hickerson's protege. Hickerson was embarrassed by that and climbed in the ring with him, and Brian Lee beat him. And that's how we got here, because Brian was going against Hickerson in a championship match. And then we showed you earlier today the double count out. The belt held up. Phil Hickerson quit. He said, I'm out of here. So Brian Lee is in the tournament trying to beat Tommy Lane right now. The winner of this match goes to the finals.
And across the ring from whoever wins this one will be Mean Mike Miller. And out of that match will come the new CWA champion.
Mike Davis tripped him up. Boy, you had to suspect.
Yep.
Something like that was going to happen with just from seeing these guys operate as a tag team. Brian Lee's head slammed into the top turnbuckle. Tommy Lane thinks he's got him going now. He slams his head into another turnbuckle across the way. Set down on him. Here's a cover. Might wrap it up. Count is two. No, Brian Lee kicks out at the two count.
Boy, he's big enough to do it, too. It's one thing that Lee has got going for him is all of the physical attributes that you need to be a champion. Into the rope, but look at that Tommy Lane handling.
Got him with that upper arm. Powered him right down to the mat. Cover again by Tommy Lane. Yeah, there's no way he was going to hold him that time. As Brian Lee just threw him right off of it.
Pulling up on the chin, pushing down on the head as he's trying to twist the big neck of Brian Lee. And Lee flailing back with that right hand, puts Lane into the corner. And a reversal as he is thrown right in to referee Jerry Calhoun. That cues Mike Davis to come up on the ringside.
Whoa.
Nail Davis. He's got Tommy Lane down. Look at this. Two.
Three.
Brian Lee beats
not one, but both of the rock and roll RPMs here. Tommy Lane pinned, and Brian Lee is going to go to the finals. We're going to have a couple of big guys in the finals, Mean Mike Miller and Brian Lee.
That's up a super CWA championship match, as the RPMs can't believe it, with not but one in the ring, but one on the outside, and they still ended up having a loss go to Tommy Lane, and the winner is Brian Lee. We're going to take time out. Be back in a moment.
Wrestling fans watching Channel 7 want to remind you, action coming to Owensboro, Kentucky on Friday, December 16th at the Sports Arena. Action Wednesday night, the Evansville Coliseum opening up Scott Steiner against Mike Davis. Brian Adams takes on Tommy Lane. A CWA title match, Brian Lee takes on Mean Mike Miller. A big bounty match, the 300-pound Pit Viper, the mask wrestler, we're told he'll be there with his 13-foot snake, will take on Jeff Jarrett. A special challenge, Southern Tag title match, Robert Fuller and Jimmy Golden with Sylvia and Downtown Bruno take on Rick Casey and superstar Bill Dundee. Then a return grudge battle. Bill Dundee has a score to settle over the injury to his son Jamie, and he's going to try to settle that score in Evansville Wednesday night. Superstar Bill Dundee climbs into the ring against the big 315-pound Sid Vicious. Don't miss the action, all coming this Wednesday night at the Evansville Coliseum. Six big matches, including that big super grudge match. See you there.
The tough battles. The superstar has battled them all, and he may be in for one of the toughest battles of his life. Bill Dundee involved with Sid Vicious. Let's go back and look at what happened on television and how this all got started.
Robert Fuller, I'm going to tell you, your goofy cousin, fat boy over here, this idiot with dyed black hair, and that woman from the red light district, I don't like you, don't want nothing to do with you, and I'm sending you down flat, big boy. Now I'm going to go wrestle. What do you think of that?
I guess that's kind of pushed it without
that
any
is, Daddy. That is.
Is just the way
I'm
it is.
I'm going to give you a little kiss, son.
Uh-oh. You might expect it. 4-on-1. Look at the stable. That's when they shine. Get a good look at them right there. Pickerson. Jamie Dundee jumps off the ring, fires down on Robert Fuller. Here's Sid Vicious coming out. Oh, my goodness. Sid's got the Japanese sleeper on Jamie. Come on, Sid. Put him down. Leave him alone.
He was simply trying to help his dad out. Jumped down on Robert Fuller, and Sid Vicious takes him out of here. Now they're getting him up. Watch the neck. As they go taking him out. Well, it was a match that was scheduled with Keith Garrick going against Bill Dundee, but of course, Bill Dundee did not want Jamie to be around here today with Sid in the
I
studio.
Understand. Yeah.
And so Billy sent in an interview we'd like for you to see.
You know, Robert Fuller, any man, it doesn't matter what you do for a living, whether you're a doctor, you're a football player, and everything in between. If the son just wants to follow in the footsteps, you can't be no more prouder than that. And mine wanted to do that. Now, you came out there on last week on television. That was all a load of... Well, you know what it was. You no more wanted me to join the stud stable and fly to the moon. What you did, you had that big idiot Sid Vicious hiding behind that curtain, and it was me you came out there to hurt. But it never ended up that way. Because I think, just like you, Fuller, I think he's a coward. Now, my boy jumped on your back, and I was as proud of him when we went back and watched that tape for doing what he did. And anybody out there would have been the same way. I mean, if you're down there and your son comes to help you, you can't ask for no more, brother. If there'd been a whole battalion full of people, he wouldn't have cared. He came to help his dad. And you can't do no more than ask for a boy that would do that. And that big gorilla you had hidden behind that curtain was to hurt me, not him. But he did hurt him. And I done told you from day one, if anybody did it, I was going to try to take him out. And I think last week when I went to the ring, there was more emotion, more anger, more everything. And Bill Dundee wasn't thinking straight. Because like I've told you a million times before, wrestling is physical chess. And you got to wait for one guy to make a mistake and somebody capitalizes on it. And you did that right, Vicious. But you didn't think about doing it. I made the mistake. And now my neck hit that top steel rope, and that's what we call them. We'll go out every week and say the top rope, the bottom rope, whatever rope, three ropes around the ring. But the thing is, it ain't rope. It's a steel cable in there. And when my neck hit it, the lights went out, and I really don't know what happened. And I'm not making no excuses. what I did do wrong, Jimmy, and I told this kid I'm going to kill that Sid Vicious, and I didn't do it. So I let him down, I let me down, and I'm sure all the people that like Bill Dundee, I let them down. But I did it in a sheer anger, rage, or whatever. I wasn't thinking straight. But I've talked to Jamie, I've talked to myself, and what I used to do, I'm going back to doing, brother. It's playing physical chess. Now, all the big monsters is coming here, and we're going to run guys off, and we're going to do this, and I'm still here. And the reason I'm still here is because Bill Dundee's a thinking wrestler. I made a mistake, but I'm not making no more mistakes, brother. Sid Vicious, you're 6'6", 300 pounds, and I'm 5'7", and 200 pounds. And I came and fought your fight. Punched myself out, you may say. That would be like Sugar Ray Leonard fighting Tyson and just throwing lefts and rights because he couldn't do it no more, and Tyson knocked him out. That's what I did. I was so mad at you, brother, I just threw caution to the wind. Well, this week, Jack, we're going on a little race because I'm going to be like Muhammad Ali. I'm going to float like a butterfly and sting like a bee. I'm going to be all over that ring, Vicious. I'm going to be all over the Coliseum. And we've got 60 minutes, because that's what the man's going to say when the bell rings, with a 60-minute time limit. If it takes 58 of them to get you tired, and you're going to get tired, brother, you're going to get tired of chasing me, I'm taking you out, Vicious, and that's the way I used to do it, and that's the way I'm going back to it. And you know why, brother? Because I'm awful proud of this boy right here, just like I told you, anybody would be. So, Sid Vicious, I got to prove a point to you and to this boy right here that Bill Dundee's better than you are. And, Fuller, I ain't forgot you, punk.
Well, of course, Billy, I know how many times he's been in there and been the underdog because guys are bigger. But, boy, he has never faced one as big as this guy.
No.
Wow, what a specimen. Let's take a look at Bill's opponent, Sid Vicious.
Do not adjust your set. This man is not an illusion. He is not an artist's conception. He is not a figment of your imagination. He is real. He stands 6 feet, 7 inches. He weighs over 315 pounds. He is Sid Vicious. Sid Vicious, without a doubt, the most awesome figure in professional wrestling today. His measurements are almost unbelievable. His neck is 24 3/4 inches. His chest expands to over 59 inches. His biceps, an incredible 26 1/2 inches. And at the ends of these powerful arms are 2 12-inch fists. Supported by true-like legs that can lift over 1,200 pounds. Combine these measurements, and you have a totally amazing athlete, Sid Vicious.
The video on him. Now we got him for real, David.
Boy, I tell you what, he's stepping into the ring right now. He weighs over 300 pounds. He goes over to Chris Frazier, not even a referee in there. Here comes the referee, Jerry Calhoun. He grabbed Chris Frazier, picks him up, throws him down to the mat. Chris weighs in a little over 200, over 300 for Sid Vicious. Look at that.
Oh, Vicious took him up there. He started, it looked like, to get that Shinomanaki on him, that Japanese sleeper. He just puts a knee down, 1, 2, 3, and that is it. Reaches down and slaps him upside the face and kicks him in the ribs.
Is the match over? I blinked my eyes for a second. I didn't realize this was so little competition for Sid Vicious in there, but it's like Mama said, it bees that way sometimes.
Well, it didn't take long for him to do it, Dave.
22 seconds is all it took. Sid Vicious overpowering Chris Frazier.
Okay, we got more action in the finals of the CWA heavyweight title tournament coming up in just a moment.
Take a look at him returning to the CWA area, Rick Casey.
You stayed with me through thick and thin. You watched me lose, you watched me win. step off of the ground. You never one time let me down. And you put me on a natural high, and I can fly, I can fly. I was drowning in a sea of make-believe, as helpless as a fallen leaf. You gave your hand to me that day,
the match gets the CWA heavyweight title. It's Mean Mike Miller out of Baton Rouge, Louisiana, going against Brian Lee.
Good microphone.
The microphone, unfortunately, is on.
Here I am, baby.
I know you're here.
Downtown Bruno. I guess, what happened to your partner? He realized that I was back with the stable.
He'll be back in just a moment running you out of here, I hope.
Oh, come on now.
Miller going against Brian Lee. A couple of big guys. Miller at 260. Brian Lee at almost 250. Brian Lee is on a roll right now, but he is going against one of the most rugged individuals to be around in a long, long time. As Lance told you during the preliminary match, he has quite a reputation, especially out on the West Coast. Mean Mike Miller.
See, that's exactly right, Dave. You got to understand, it ain't always the size that counts. Because, you know, the old story, it ain't the size of the dog in the fight. It's the size of the fight, the dog, you understand? And the bigger they are, the harder they fall. It's all about toughness. It's all about being a survivor. It's about intestinal fortitude. And Mike Miller's got all that. Plus, he's got Downtown Bruno in his corner, you understand?
Yeah.
So he can't lose.
Yeah, Downtown Bruno in his corner, which is the way Mean Mike Miller ended up getting the victory in that preliminary match, because Downtown Bruno distracted his opponent, Brickhouse Brown.
Give me a break. Oh, here comes your buddy here. I better let him up before he has a fit and starts crying or something. Here you go, Lance Russell.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Don't cry, Lancer.
Brian Lee and Mike Miller going for the CWA heavyweight title. The belt vacated, actually was held up by promoter Eddie Marlin. But the former holder of it, Phil Hickerson, said, I quit. I'm out of here. So Brian Lee, who had been challenging him for the belt, got into the tournament, won his preliminary match. Mean Mike Miller, as we said, with a little help from Downtown Bruno, won his preliminary match, and here we are with a belt at stake.
Well, I think you'd have to do nothing else to experience alone. I have to say that Miller is the favorite in this championship match. But Brian Lee kind of let Phil Hickerson know that just because you've got experience, that's not going to be enough to beat him. He beat Hickerson last week. We saw it right here.
Well, he sure did. And then today in the preliminary, he beat both of the Rock and Roll RPM.
That's right.
So can't count Brian Lee out of it, certainly. Oh, look at that. Mike Miller. Oh, look at Brian Lee battling back. These two really going at each other. 2 minutes, 35 seconds gone in the championship match. By the way, I didn't mention the time limit. We go to a TV time limit. If time runs out and there is no winner, the winner will be decided by a coin flip. I, for one, hope somebody wins it right there in the ring.
Yeah. When you have to have a winner, that's the only way you can do it. And situation being, I hate to see that. Oh, look at this. Uh-oh.
Look out. That's how Miller won the first match.
That's
Bruno
right.
Climbed up on that apron. Miller again going with a reverse neck breaker. This time on Brian Lee. He's got a count of two. Might be it.
Whoa! He got his leg over that rope just in time.
Brian Lee up on his feet. Mike Miller thought he had won it, I think. Brian Lee's got his shoulders down. He got it. Brian Lee has just become the CWA heavyweight champion. in what has to be considered an upset win over Mean Mike Miller.
What a major, major win for young Brian Lee and Mike Miller, who just knew he was going to take this kid, is furious. The new CWA heavyweight title holder is Brian Lee. Okay, Davey, we're going to take time out after that crowning of the new champ. Back in a moment.
I want to remind wrestling fans on Friday, December 16th, action in Owensboro, Kentucky at the Sporting Arena starting at 8 o'clock. Evansville Wednesday night. Here's the card. Scott Steiner opens up against Mike Davis. Brian Adams against Tommy Lane. A CWA heavyweight title match. Brian Lee against Mean Mike Miller. A bounty match. The Pit Viper coming to town. The masked wrestler, 300 pounds, to take on Jeff Jarrett. Southern Tag Team title bout. Robert Fuller and Jimmy Golden with Sylvia and Downtown Bruno put their belts on the line against Rick Casey and superstar Bill Dundee. And then following that, a big return match as this man, superstar Bill, gets his shot at Sid Vicious. You're going to be busy in Evansville Wednesday night.
That's right, and that's just how I like it. You know, you can sneak up on somebody and you do it the first time, that's your fault. You do it the second time and it would be my fault. And you're not doing it no more, Fuller. You're not doing it no more. Now, the guy I got coming in for the tag match is Rick Casey. Oh, and girls, if you ain't seen, oh, you've seen him because he's been there before. He used to wrestle as a yellow Rose, Rick Casey. Good-looking cowboy, brother. Well, I'm just going to tell you something, Fuller. He don't like you and your stinking stable because you tried to hurt him 5-6 months ago in Alabama. Well, it didn't work, brother, and he accepted the challenge. So he's coming right here Wednesday night to the Evansville Coliseum. And when I go back to wrestle you, Vicious, I'm going to be one half of the Southern Tag Team titles. That's right, Fuller and Golden, because we're going to beat you, brother. We're coming to not to play with you. We may play with you a little bit, but then we're going to show off and we're going to beat you because we want to be the champions. And then you said, Vicious, oh, I'm not selling you short, boy. You get it? Nah. You ain't got enough between the ears to get that punk. Well, you're going to get this. If I go to pick up a chair and belt your brains out with it, that's exactly what I'm going to do with it. Oh, you're a big, tough athlete, brother, but we may play a little bit of cat and mouse. The man will say 1 hour time limit, and that's where it takes 58 minutes for me to get you tired. I'm taking you out, sucker, because I don't like you, Sid Vicious, and every time I look at you, I think of my boy Jimmy, and I think what you did to that little scrawny neck of his. That's right, he's just a boy. He's just got a little 11, 12-inch neck. Well, mine may not be as big as yours, Vicious, but you're not going to break it. Come on, try it, punk, because I'm going to be standing right in the middle of the ring waiting on you. One half of the Southern Tag Team Champions. I'll see you in Evansville, boy.
Hi, everybody. I'm Lee Marshall with your Super Clash 3 update, and things just continue to grow more exciting by the day. Fans, if you didn't see it, the South African mercenary, Colonel De Beers, did one of the most despicable things seen in quite some time. In a match in which he was not involved, he jumped America's hero, Sergeant Slaughter, literally pile-driving him into the cement floor of the arena. Now more than ever, Sergeant Slaughter wants Colonel De Beers in the ring at Super Clash 3, and he's got him. But this won't be any ordinary match. This will be a boot camp match. And fans, if you have never seen a boot camp match, well, let me give you the Reader's Digest version of what that means. If you can bring it into the ring, baby, then you can use it on the other guy. Let's hear now from America's hero, Sergeant Slaughter.
Nobody does what you did to me. I've been hit by every possible weapon in the world. Nobody's ever made me go on a stretcher, and it's the last time for you, Colonel De Beers.
The boot camp match is going to be exciting, but so is the Indian strap match. This is going to feature Wahoo McDaniel taking on the raging bull, Manny Fernandez. Wahoo demanded it, Fernandez agreed to it, and you will see them settle the score once and for all in a strap match. You're also going to see a six-person tag team match, the AWA champions of the world. They are bad company. Their partner, Medusa Michelli, as they take on the Top Guns, and their partner, three times ladies champion, that's Wendy Richter. Also, finally, we're going to settle this thing once and for all. We will have one world heavyweight champion. Jerry the King Lawler, the AWA champion, brings his belt into the ring against WCCW heavyweight champion, the modern-day warrior, Kerry Von Erich. Two men walk in, one man walks out with both titles. Super Clash 3, the most historic event in wrestling history. You be a part of it.
There it is, CWA Heavyweight Championship belt, and boy, here is a young man who just won it today. The new champion, congratulations, Brian Lee. Boy, it's not that we're putting you down, but we got to say, I think you were the underdog against the experience of Mike Miller. And yeah. Great win, Brian.
Thank you, Mr. Russell.
This has been a dream of a lifetime. It's came true. I've seen a lot of great champions hold this belt. I don't want to be just another closet champion. I'll defend it anytime, anywhere. Just name the date.
Well, we are very proud of you, and I think you've done such a super job in the short time that you've been in the area. And I got... Hey, come on, Mike.
You get up here. Hey, I beat you fast right in the middle of that ring. That is my belt right there, Lance Russell. Don't you be shaking hands with this, man.
Hey, there's not going to be any trouble out here.
Yeah, there ain't going to be no trouble because I come out here. I told him.
Hey, listen to me. He's had two matches here today. He won both of them. And he is the CWA heavyweight champion. The people's proud of him. And there won't be a title match.
That belt should be mine, Randy Hales. And I tell you what, if he's any kind of champion at all, you put that belt on the line, punk. That's all you are, punk, to me. I've paid my dues in this business. You put the line. You put that belt on the line against me, brother, and I tell you what, I'll take that belt home with me. I'll take it home with me.
Excuse me, Randy. Like I said, I'm not going to be just another closet champion. He wants a match. Give it to him anytime.
Well, I tell you, Brian, one thing is champion. It's good to be brave and all, but Randy.
I have respect for the desire and the heart that he's had here today. He says he wants to be a fighting champion, Lance. We'll give him a title. If he wants to defend the title, I'm proud of him for doing that. So we'll go back and change the card.
Well, I'm delighted with that, too, but I got to have a little talk. Brian Lee, the new CWA heavyweight title holder. And we're going to take time out. Be back in just a moment. Got time for this son of a gun. It was a standby match that you announced at the beginning of the program. Our new champion, Brian Lee, and we are tickled to death to say that the young man has got the belt. It was a good win over Mike Miller when you beat a guy that big and that tough.
Well, it was indeed. We are looking forward to this six-man match, though. We got a good one to go here. Right now, we got Jimmy Golden and Robert Fuller, the Tennessee Stud, and Mike Davis of the Rock and Roll RPMs in the ring. Across the way, Scott Steiner, Todd Morton, and Brian Adams. Six-man tag team match. Hey, don't forget downtown Bruno and Sylvia over in the corner of the Stud Stable. But this one should be a good one. I always feel sorry for referees in a six-man match. What?
I have been really impressed with this Brian Adams. Adams is out of Hawaii.
Hawaii.
And they call him the American Ninja, and he uses a lot of that martial arts stuff.
Yeah, he carries a kendo stick into the ring with him. He will hand it out of the ring, though, before we get started. Sylvia has a kendo stick in her hand, too, and she's been known to use it frequently during the match.
I don't even want to hear you, much less listen to you. Robert Fuller starting out against Scott Steiner.
I feel good. I want to talk a little bit. I'm back with the stable. You know, all these people, all these wrestling fans thought I really wanted to be their friend. I really wanted to be their favorite. Well, they start wrong. I made a mistake. I had a hard time sleeping at night after I left the Scott stable because I realized I was stuck with an idiot like Gary Young and a bum like Cactus Jack, and I had no business being with them when I am the greatest manager in the history of professional wrestling, bar none. And now I'm out here once again with all the greatest people in professional wrestling. Robert Fuller, Jimmy Gold, Mike Davis, Tommy Lane, the beautiful Sylvia, Mean Mike Miller, Sid Vicious. And it's my own fault for ever siding with those two punks in the debate between the stable. And you know what? Robert Fuller was gracious enough to let me come back into the Stud Stable. They beat a little bit of sense into me, sure. They busted me open a little bit, sure. They put some pain on me. I had to get some stitches in my head. All of that, sure, that's true. But he took me back into the stable because he was trying to teach me a lesson, Lance, because he knew deep down in his heart that Robert Fuller was number one and downtown Bruno was number one, and we had to be together because the number one wrestler and the number one manager go together like bacon and egg. Scotch and soda, Laurel and Hardy, freaking frat. You know what I'm talking about?
You deserve each other, Bruno. I am delighted. I can only say that. Todd Morton in with Mike Davis in this six-man, and Davis fires him over, but Morton held on. On, and now Mike Davis hooks the rope, Dave.
Hey, Lance, you know what? Everybody thinks Bill Dundee's not here today. Well, I happen to know he is. He's standing underneath the ring. Get it? Standing underneath the ring. Hi, Mom. Hey, my mom's probably in Pittsburgh watching because she's the one that told me that bees that way sometimes. And I want her to know that I'm back at the stable, and I'm proud to be back at the stable. And I want to talk to all the people and all the cities and towns, like all them scumbags that's in the front row in Evansville, Indiana, like all them idiots all through Tennessee, like them goofs in Louisville and Nashville. I don't want nobody liking me. Nobody. Because I don't like you. I would.
You don't have any worry about that, Bruno. You don't have any worry about that at all.
You know what's real funny? The people, when I was injured, when I was laid on the floor, hurt, the people that picked me up and carried me away from the ringside area, back to the dressing room, back to the first aid area, they thought that I appreciated it. They thought I liked them. Well, I was using them because Jack and Gary were too stupid and ignorant to save me. So, idiot, I used them.
Here comes Bryan Adams into the ring. Look at him.
315-pounder out of Hawaii, Bryan Adams.
Jimmy Gold and Bryan Adams, good match. Two big guys, both of them with good height. Adams with even more weight than Jimmy Golden has in there.
Didn't Bryan Adams used to be a fly-by-night rock star? Cuts like a knife, nah. I guess it's a different one or something, I don't know. Maybe he got sick of rock and roll and decided to be a wrestler. Well,
yeah, I think it is a different one, Bruno. Oh, boy. Don't I hear your mama calling you again right now? Bryan Adams with a big bear hug. Look at him with big Jimmy Golden up off the floor.
Long to counter that maneuver, did it, D.B.?
Yeah, just rake him in the eyes.
Countered him in the eyes. That's exactly what he did.
No, that wasn't the eyes. That was a nerve bow with the optic nerve. Yeah. You just got to use it in my terminology.
Reversal by Adams. Mike Davis goes under the bear hug.
Again.
Come on, Mikey. Come on, baby.
Bryan Adams, huge fella from Hawaii. Holding that big bear hug, and Mike Davis goes after the ears to get it broken.
Look who didn't want the tag, Robert Fuller. He still hadn't gotten the tag, has he?
Boy, he knows how to pull that hand back in a hurry, doesn't
he? Both of them, yeah. He didn't want to be anywhere in danger of any, even an inadvertent tag. Golden goes back in instead.
My daddy was here, Dave. You would talk like that.
Yeah, I would. Oh, Steiner run back into the corner now by Jimmy Golden so that the whole stud stable can work on him back there. Now, here comes Fuller in. Golden holding Scott Steiner up. Fuller with that big boot.
Kicking Scott Steiner right in the midsection while Golden holds him. Snapmare over the shoulder. Went in for a reverse face block, let go, and tagged on to Mike Davis. Davis with a whip on Steiner. Oh, look at the muscle man. Boomed him.
Whoa, look at it.
Todd Morton in.
The guys are cheating. They're all in the ring. Nobody's tagging.
Oh, my goodness. We got them all in there.
Come on, stable. Go for Uncle Bruno.
Adams coming outside the ring after Fuller. Inside the ring, Todd Morton with Mike Davis down. Referee Jerry Calhoun is over here with Adams. Fuller loaded the boot up.
Loaded that boot up.
Todd Morton. That's going to be it, Dave.
Yeah, he counted him out. 5 minutes, 27 seconds of time. Stud Stable is going to take the win. Give the boot an assist. 5:27 the time.
Number one.
Yeah, okay. Robert Fuller holding the hands up. Stable, number one, particularly when you got it loaded up like you did that boot in there. Well, it's been an exciting day. A tough loss for the team of Adams, Steiner, and Morton. But what a day it's been, particularly for one young Bryan Lee.
I beg your pardon. Yes, indeed. Yeah, Bryan Lee has really done well today. Won the preliminary match against Tommy Lane and made it into the finals against Mean Mike Miller. Miller, as we said, had to be considered at least a bit of a favorite going into the match. But Bryan Lee took the win and the belt. And it looked like Mean Mike Miller had him beat. But all of a sudden, Bryan Lee outsmarts him and got those shoulders down, held him there for the three count. And we have a brand new CWA heavyweight champion.
Let me tell you, I'm impressed with this new champion, too. He is green and young, but boy, what a fine young fellow this guy is. Bryan Lee, our new CWA heavyweight champion. Next week, we'll see you. For Dave Brown, Lance Russell saying bye-bye, everybody.
The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, namely the promoters of Championship Wrestling. We'll be right back.